if you closed a transaction in the past using down payment assistance? Raise your hand. Loud, proud, and high. Okay, I would say it's a good 20% of the room. So we have a lot of opportunity. A lot of opportunity. So what have we learned today so far, especially from Danielle Blake that brought a lot of information with her. Where's Danielle? Thank you for all that you shared. So we know that the median condo purchase price in Miami is what? $225,000. The median purchase price for a single family is $325,000. That's a huge gap. And then we have median income of $52,000. There's a gap there. I know you're thinking about it. There's a gap. How do I get my buyers that make $52,000 a year into a $225,000 condo? A lot of people are renting. We have a lot of first-time home buyers renting. The rents out there are crazy. People are spending a lot of money on rent. And because of that, they're living paycheck to paycheck, and they don't have the means to save for a down payment, right? So how do we bridge that gap? We use what's called down payment assistance. I got a quick story for you. I want to know which one of you, okay? And this is a Tom Ferry story. I've taken a bit of my own. The year is 1932. The year is 1932. Two different shoe sales representatives, two different shoe sales reps are shipped to another country, a very remote country, with a population of 2 million people. The first guy gets off the plane and he says, oh my goodness, 2 million people, nobody's wearing shoes. I'm a shoe salesman. Nobody's wearing shoes. What am I gonna do? OMG. There's no opportunity here. The second guy gets off the plane and he says, oh my goodness gracious, 2 million people here, nobody's wearing shoes. What an incredible opportunity. So think about that, which one are you, right? And the reason why I mention that is there's a lot of opportunity when it comes to first time home buyers, down payment assistance, low down payment loans. The lenders in the room, we know refinances, when rates go up, what happens? They go away. Refinances sometimes go away. Luxury buyers, realtors in the room, luxury buyers, they sometimes go away, right? Depending on what's going on in the economy. We all know that foreign buyers sometimes go away depending on what's going on in the global economy, right? But the first-time home buyer is here to stay. The first-time home buyer does not go away. You know what? And you can go ahead and ask my parents in 1984 purchased their first home at an interest rate of 13%. So when a first-time home buyer comes up to me these days and they say, you know what, Albert, it's not a good time to buy, I say, my parents paid 13% for their mortgage in 1984. And you know what? They didn't care. They didn't care because we were living in a trailer. We were living in a trailer in Medley, Florida with no yard, and it wasn't their own. And they paid 13% for their mortgage. And here I am today, thanks to them. So with a median purchase price of $225,000 for a condo in Miami, Florida, there is opportunity. A median purchase price of $225,000 for a condo, this project, this type of building is financeable. We're about to find out now from the lender panel in just a few minutes, the programs that are out there. I've seen it with my own eyes, 95% financing. 95% financing on a condo with no reserves. Okay, and we're gonna learn about that in just a minute. All right. It's time to introduce my guest. My guest today is someone who's very, very well known. As a matter of fact, most of you in this room know who he is, okay? I want to introduce you now to not the expert, the authority. Miami-Dade County's authority when it comes to down payment assistance. Everybody, give it up for Mr. Eric Johnson! you got files to work on and closings to get done. By the way, this man next to me here is partly responsible during the last 9 months, partly responsible for putting 250 families into home that they can afford. We're going to talk about the top four down payment assistance programs in Miami-Dade County. Go ahead.
First of all, it's an honor and a pleasure to be here. Thank you for the invitation and opportunity to come here today to talk to you about down payment assistance, closing cost programs, how it works, dispel some of the myths, take out the information that you may have received that's not accurate and up to date, and we're going to clear all that up today. We're also working on a new realtor training that will be rolling out somewhere in the September-October range. And there is an update for the lenders and closing agents that will also be coming up in September. So we're trying to tighten things up a little bit, but we'll be back in action. We work better than ever. And I thank you for the opportunity to be here and speak to you today. So, other down payment and closing cost assistance programs are available here in Miami-Dade County. Our program, which is the Miami-Dade Economic Advocacy Trust Homeownership Assistance Program, we offer up to $7,250. This is via a zero interest, no payment loan. I'll go over some basics once I'm done with the list. As far as general information, you're going to want to know about down payment assistance programs after we go through the listings here that Albert compiled. So that you know, so that you understand, the four main programs we're going to be discussing, they're going to be on your slides. These are programs that are funded on a regular basis. They do not run out of money or funds. Okay, so anybody that's telling you that there's not money available is either badly misinformed or they're in God's secret truth. Okay, so these are all programs that do have money, do close loans 12 months out of the year. Again, there's no monthly payment. It's a zero interest, no payment loan. Our loan is forgiven after 10 years of owner occupancy. So if a borrower lives in the property for the first 10 years without doing the cash out refinance or without selling the property, our funds are forgiven. The Florida Housing Finance Corporation. This is one of two bond programs that are in operation. The Florida Housing Finance Corporation is a down payment assistance program active in every county in the state of Florida. So outside of Miami-Dade County, which would be the focus, any of you who do business outside of Miami-Dade County, you can use the Florida Housing Finance Corporation bond program. It's good in every county in the state of Florida. They provide $7,500 in down payment assistance. It's also zero interest. It's no payment. These are funds that are not forgiven. So upon sale of the property or after 30 years, assuming that the members are still alive at that point in time, the money may be payable at that point in time. They do have a different kind of grant. It goes up to 3% of the purchase price. On the information sheets that you have out here today, it does have their contact information as far as phone number and website. Again, there's no monthly payment to their program, and the grant that they provided, 3%, can be forgiven under certain circumstances. Miami-Dade County Housing Finance Authority. This would be the second bond program. This is a bond program specific to Miami-Dade County. They provide now newly up to $15,000 in down payment assistance. This is a zero interest, no payment loan. It is also a loan that is not forgiven, so at the end of 30 years, it may become due and payable at that point in time or upon sale. The fourth one is the Miami-Dade Department of Public Housing and Community Development. PHCD receives a bulk of the down payment assistance, subsidy funds for Miami-Dade County, in addition to their first-time homebuyer program, which I'll go into detail about in just a minute. They do also have an infill program where the county deeds lots over to developers the developers build new properties on these lots and sell them at a sale price that does not exceed $205,000. Their first-time homebuyer program provides up to $80,000 in assistance. The range of that fund is from $40,000 to $80,000. This is the one program we were discussing that there is an actual repayment to. Borrowers have a 30-year mortgage. There is a $100 payment for the first 5 years. The remaining 25 years, the remaining balance is amortized at a 0 to 3% interest rate. So it does have a payback to it, but you are talking $40,000 to $80,000, which is huge amounts of buying power, especially the low and very low income families.
So can you just quickly touch on why it is that these programs do not run out of money? So I know that some of the myths out there are, well, so-and-so is out of money, you know, you can't use them because they're out of money. How is it that these programs are continuously funded?
Okay, for the bond programs, they're called bond programs because they actually sell mortgage revenue bonds on the open market on an as-needed basis. They have a regular budget with the state of Florida that does not have to go through state legislation in order to have the funds that are provided for their assistance with the tax to their first mortgage. So they're a state agency that's responsible for all the statewide funding of down payment assistance, so they take their monies off the top. The rest of it is distributed to the other programs that the Board of Housing Finance Corporation operates. Similar for the Miami-Dade County Bond Program, they sell mortgage revenue bonds on an as-needed basis, so they have been up and running and funding for at least the last 20 years that I've been in affordable housing, without exception, nonstop. Now, for our program, which is the Miami-Dade Economic Advocacy Trust Homeownership Assistance Program, and the Public Housing Community Development First-Time Homebuyer Program, we have a special set of money that is allocated by the state of Florida that comes to Dade County and only to Dade County on a Miami-Dade basis. Quick sidebar. Realtors in the room that do or sell commercial real estate, please raise your hand. Commercial real estate. Okay? I want to thank you all very much because you fund our program. The documented surtax stamp program, which was reenacted for another 20 years back in 2012, takes a portion of the documentary surtax stamps that are paid on commercial real estate deals. That is how our program is funded. The state of Florida sends us money on a monthly basis, every month, without fail. We do not know the amounts of money that are coming to us, but with the exception of the first year after the market crash, where I think we got maybe $750,000 for the entire year. Outside of that, our allocation, which is 8% of the fund, has been running anywhere from $2 to $4 million annually. For the last couple of years, we've been running about $3 to $3.5 million. So we actually have a carryover at this point in time is $3 million. So if we get a dime for the next year, we can still operate our program for an 18-month situation. So these are programs that are funded on an ongoing basis. They will not run out of funds.
Thanks, Eric.
What about, the topic is condos today, right? Condo financing. Any restrictions on condominiums here with these programs?
Absolutely not. No restrictions whatsoever with regard to money being used to purchase of a condominium. We do not manage, dictate, regulate, have any say-so whatsoever in the type of property a borrower buys. The programs that you see here only allow for single-family financing, but whether a borrower chooses a condo, a townhome, or a single-family detached house is totally, strictly, and completely up to the individual home buyer. We encourage actually purchase of condominiums because it makes it more affordable, especially in the low and very low income categories, of which half of the funds we disperse must be used to go to families that are at or below 80% of median income for Miami-Dade County, and you do also have the income chart for Miami-Dade County.
Quick and easy, down payment assistance, right? So if you had to maybe list them in order, what would you say, and how much time does it take to close a deal from contract to closing deal?
Okay. Before I answer that, I'm going to tell you, as a real estate professional, or as a lender, or for the closing agents, I'm going to give a shout out and love to the nonprofit housing counseling agencies that are here in the room. We're going to talk about them as well.
Let's have them stand up real quick. Housing counseling agencies, please stand up.
For the housing counseling agency, can you ask for a resource at the center? With the Broward Urban League, they do wonderful things up in Broward County. Stephanie Johnson with Trinity Empowerment. I saw Juan Carlos when I walked in the room with Central Campesino. Have Chester Bishop over here with the Housing Foundation of America, who operates in Miami-Dade, Broward, and Palm Beach County. They do have a new branch that is now located down in Condo. And I will tell you, there's a website that Chester's put together that's on the sound color sheet of paper that gives good information as far as what's happening in Broward and Palm Beach counties. Assistance has been qualifying. We're looking to get that further up and running. So we'll talk a little bit more about the housing counseling agencies and the home verification in just a moment. For you, you're going to get involved in down payment assistance programs. There are four things you're going to absolutely need to know in order to be able to best navigate through a deal. Number one, exactly which program you're getting money from. As you will tell in just a minute, when I answer the question having to do with time frames, one of three county agencies that offers down payment assistance, they could not be more different if they had to be. So you do need to know exactly what program your borrower is seeking money from. Obviously, you want to know how much assistance they're going to be receiving. Borrowers do not apply directly to the down payment assistance program for money and funds. You're going to need to select a loan officer that knows how to read, follow instructions, and use a calculator. When in doubt, give them a text. If they cannot read sheets and guidelines, there's going to be trouble. If they cannot follow instructions because they're responsible for the file and the condition of the file and quality of the file that comes to down payment assistance, you're going to have problems. Using a calculator, they don't calculate things right, then bad things happen. And so that you do understand the down payment assistance component is after the borrower is already under contract with the clock ticking. And by the time we receive a typical file coming to our office for down payment assistance, the bar is either 1 to 2 days, 1 to 2 weeks away from closing, or they should have closed 1 or 2 weeks ago. Next thing you want to know is, what are the requirements of the program? What are the time frame? What documents have to be submitted? The fourth thing is more for the borrowers. They want to know what strings are attached to the program, but that's something that your borrower has to do so they don't get cold feet at the last minute. Now, answering your question. For time frames, the two bond programs. This would be the Florida Housing Finance Corporation bond program and the Miami-Dade Housing Finance Authority bond programs. They will add zero, ningún, nada, tiempo to the time of the processing of the loan. The down payment assistance is processed at the exact same time that first mortgage is. The lenders front the money at time of closing, so they literally add no time whatsoever to the time it takes to get the loan done. For our particular program, you're talking about a window that's about 3 to 4 weeks. This includes the submission of the file, the review of the file, the processing and approval. We are a Miami-Dade County agency. We do not have a printing press in our office. Our loans are funded directly to the closing agents in the room. Much love. By the Finance Department of Miami-Dade County. At this point in time, that process alone is taking at least a week. We do not have any control over that process whatsoever. Okay, the finance department processes thousands of transactions for Miami-Dade County on a regular basis. Our funds are processed on an emergency basis, which gets us a weak turnabout. For the public housing community development, obviously, if you're getting $40,000 to $80,000, there's additional due diligence with regards to what they do to process and approve that. That is going to run you somewhere in the 1 to 2 months. In given situations, maybe a little bit longer, but that particular program is going to take at least 1 to 2 months for the total processing, approval, and funding of those loans. So, as you can see, just for the county agencies, you have 3 to pushing 4 weeks, no time whatsoever, or 1 to 2 months. And that's the reason why, as a real estate professional, you want to either get informed or get details with regard to exactly what down payment assistance program is being used.
So we were talking about the housing counseling agencies a few minutes ago, and so tell us about what exactly it is that they do and how important it is for them to be involved here with these programs.
I really wish that we had the opportunity to hear from Judy Ayers Britton. She is the regional head of Housing Counseling Agency for U.S. HUD. She could give you a lot more information and details than I would be able to provide for you. I can tell you recently from a meeting that we had, the Housing Counseling Agencies in Miami-Dade County, of which there are 14 HUD-affiliated agencies, they educated over 18,000 potential homebuyers in 2016. They did over 3,500 one-on-one counseling sessions, and in addition to providing the monthly home education workshops that they have throughout the county, which provides details with regard to the home buying process. Oh, by the way, they bring in lenders to talk about getting a mortgage. They bring in actual real estate professionals that talk about shopping for a home. They bring in closing agents that actually do the presentation on closing on a loan. So if you really want to get more involved in the home buying process and you want to be able to give your information to any of the agencies which run anywhere from 1,000 to 2,000 people through the workshops a year, get in contact with the housing counseling agencies that you have a list of that we work with directly, and you may be able to present at their program and share your wealth and knowledge with them. On our particular program, we do require in-person homebuyer education through one of the approved agencies that we have in conjunction with HUD. The reason why we do in-person education versus online is very simple. I would not be attending to any online class that may be in existence. I've yet to see one that has a significant amount of detail with regard to down payment assistance and down payment programs. We want the borrowers to get the information and facts up front. If you are referring your borrowers to a HUD housing counseling agency, please do understand this. HUD requires that they perform a home buyer readiness test for every borrower that they counsel and do one-on-one sessions with. So, yes, they're going to ask for their pay stub. They're going to ask for their bank statements. They have the ability to pull soft hit credit, which does not affect their credit scores whatsoever. But they're not lenders. These are housing counseling agencies that are asked to perform actually what could be a very valuable service to you in the way of making sure that your borrower is home buyer ready. So, A, do not be afraid or do not be dismayed if your borrower that you refer is being asked to provide information to do a pre-qualification, even if you have pre-qualified or pre-approved them. This is what they have to do. Actually get to know them. You may find that they can provide a service to you at a level that you're not able to do or don't have time to do with regards to the readiness of your home buyers. Number two, and this is an important topic that we've had discussion with Judy and HUD. If at any point in time, a client that you have referred to the Housing Counseling Agency that you feel is being steered or directed to any particular anybody. Does that matter whether that be a lender, realtor, closing agent? They're not allowed or permitted to directly steer or refer clients to anyone in particular. If you do think that something like this is going on, please get in contact with me, or please get in contact with Judy S. Britton at US HUD. We will investigate it and make sure that it's taken care of. Okay? This does not work without you. We're not running as an agency between 300 to 400 plus homebuyers a year through our program without the benefit, talent, expertise of the people sitting in this room, and I thank you for that.
Yeah, so let's I'm a realtor. I've never actually had any experience with down payment assistance. I have a few buyers that are around the $50,000 range, sometimes even below, and I feel like they may qualify for some kind of assistance to help them get into one of these condos that we're trying to sell. What would be one of the things, or one of the first things that they have to do as a realtor if they got a buyer that they want to go ahead and move forward with?
First of all, I would say have your borrowers attend a first-time home education class. Home education is required either in person or online for every down payment assistance program in existence. In addition to getting that out of the way, and it shouldn't be an out-of-the-way situation, back in the day, and I'm not going to say when Tino and I used to see each other on a regular basis and run around. Back in the day when I actually did loan originations, an informed borrower is an easier borrower to deal with. They're not going to stop calling you, but as opposed to calling you two or three times a day, they're only going to call you every other day. Okay, but again, this is information that they will now have that you can have them held accountable for. Can't play dumb with you anymore. Secondly, get them pre-qualified with down payment assistance through a loan officer and lender that is approved to provide whatever down payment assistance program that they're wanting to go through based on the information that I gave you. Those are the two first steps. When you're looking at the search for contracts, once you know which program they're going through, now you have the ability to negotiate the terms of the contract much better and easier with the seller. These are fully approved borrowers. The chances that their deal is going to fall through from a lending standpoint is next to nil. They will pay full price since they're getting down payment and closing cost assistance. In a lot of cases, you don't have to negotiate a set of contribution, or if you negotiate a set of contribution and the appraisal comes in low, surprise, surprise, and the seller says, okay, I'll lower the sale price, but I'm not paying any closing costs anymore, the lender can restructure the deal, the down payment system can take care of the gap, you're still in the game.
So I mentioned the $50,000 figure because that's 100% of the area median income, but some of these programs will go up to $100,000 or more in annual income in terms of the income limits. So,
from that standpoint, and again, I can only speak for data on our program, out of the 245 families that I mentioned that we've closed in the last 9 months, our average purchase price is running $190,000. We have borrowers that have purchased condos that are anywhere in the 80, 100, 120 range. Obviously, the single families go into the twos at this point in time, but if you're talking about $50,000 getting into a condo, it is the best and easiest way to go. The down payment system can take care of what is needed, and we do those on a regular basis all day long looking for more condo business. Again, half the funds that we use have to go to families at or below 80% of median income. So if you were to look at the income track that you're talking about, people that are earning between $40,000 to $60,000, $70,000. Half of our funds have to go to these borrowers. So we're actually looking with your assistance to get those borrowers into the condo. $50,000 is an easy target income as far as being able to afford what we do.
All right, we're almost out of time. Closing remarks.
I want to ask a question or two questions from you. How many people in here as a realtor have used or worked a down payment assistance program? Okay? For the vast majority of you in the room who haven't, why not? I understand that you can't shout out or whatever, or you can. We want to hear from you. I was glad to have this opportunity today to hopefully dispel some of the myths or hesitation that you may have with regards to the use of down payment assistance. But I can assure you, if the communication lines stay open, if the realtor's in communication, the lender's in communication, the closing agent are all talking, there is no deal that cannot be overcome under any issue or time frame. Literally have a deal right now that a week ago was basically gone, done, falling apart. Got a call directly from a listing agent. Explained who we are, what was going on, dispelled some of the myths and overcame the lack of communication with no notice intended to the loan officer. I now know that her daughter's pregnant, her mother-in-law is in the hospital, and any number of things where we have nice, pleasant conversations, but all it took was a 20-minute conversation, honestly and candidly, on where we are, what is going on, what is the process, how do you help the seller and the seller seller and the seller 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 of this four-tier deal stay together so that people don't have heart attacks before you close. Okay? Communication is key. Please give us a chance and opportunity to prove ourselves. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Eric Johnson!